Dear students, in this video lecture, we are going to see about cell communication. Cell communication is also referred as signal transduction. Okay. A signal transduction pathway refers to sequence of molecular events and chemical reaction that led to a cell's response to a signal. So, how this thing has been accomplished? Before going into the explanation, we have to look at meaning for certain terms. Say, what is ligand? They are called a signal molecule. They bind to the cell surface receptors, or they can pass into cell membrane and they can bind or bound to the intracellular receptors. The next important term in the cell-cell communication is receptor protein. So, what are receptors? Receptors refers to protein usually present in cell surface which bind to ligand, that is signal molecules, and they can able to cause a response. Look at here a simple definition there for signal transduction. It refers to conversion of information in the signal into cellular response. Now we look at a list of molecule that can able to act as a signaling molecule. These signaling molecules may be hydrophilic or hydrophobic in nature. They include peptides, large proteins, individual amino acids, nucleotides, steroid molecules, lipids, sometimes even gases such as nitric oxide. They are all involving as a signaling molecule in the process of signal transduction. Look at this diagram. This shows the overall events associated there with the signal transduction pathway. Say, some factors such as the light can able to induce a signal molecule. So that signal molecule may be of a hydrophobic or hydrophilic in nature. If it is of a hydrophobic, they can able to cross there into the cell membrane. Okay, that are also basically hydrophobic in nature. And then they can bind to the intracellular receptor. However, when they are hydrophilic in nature, they bind just to the receptor present there embedded in the cell membrane. Further, the signal, when it enter in the cytoplasm, they can able to initiate a signal transduction pathway, a relay of pathways that have been mediated by various enzymes, which will finally trigger the cellular response. Say for example, when light is a factor, the natural cellular response will be a vision. So you can able to see that light. So like that, several metabolic processes in the cell could be mediated there by various kind of signal transducing pathway. So this signal transducing pathway are also called as cell to cell communication or signal transduction pathway. Look at this image that shows the overview of cell signaling, or we can say as the overall steps there involved in the cell signaling pathway. So here the signal molecule is actually epinephrine, which is triggering a cellular response of release of glucose from the glycogen. So the overall events are referred as a molecular events of cell signaling also. So the first one is a signal reception. It is the first step. The second step is a signal transduction. And the third step is a cellular response. Here signal reception involved a receptor protein. Signal transduction involves an array of various proteins or enzymes. And finally, the response. All these three processes have been explained here. We will look at the explanation shortly. Signal reception, the first step, it involves reception in the target cells, that is detection of the signaling molecule coming from outside of the cell. A chemical signal, it is also called as a ligand molecule, it is detected when the signaling molecule binds to the receptor protein that may be located at the cell surface or at the interior of the cell. Say, if it is hydrophilic in nature, it will be taken up by the receptor there present in the surface of the cell membrane, or that is in the cell surface. However, if it is a hydrophobic ligand molecule or signal molecule, they can able to traverse inside the cell membrane and they will be getting attached there to the intracellular receptor, which will further trigger the relay of events. The second step is the signal transduction. The binding of the signal molecule changes the receptor protein, that is the conformation of the receptor protein will be changing and it will be initiating a process of events. This transduction stage converts the signal to form into a specific cellular response. For this, we look at the example of the epinephrine, how it is stimulating the release of glucose. The epinephrine attached to the receptor protein that are located at the liver cell's plasma membrane, which leads to the activation of glycogen phosphorylase enzyme there at the cytosol. So this transduction phase may be consists of a single step of an enzyme, or very usually it found to have several enzymes involved in this process, and it differ from a one pathway to another pathway. The molecules that are involved in this pathway are often referred as a relay molecules, as that have been shown here in this image. You can able to see three kind of relay molecule are involved there in the taking up of the signal and converting it into a cellular response. The next stage is the cellular response. The transduced signal that have been taken inside triggers a specific response inside the cell. The response may be almost any imaginable cellular activity. Say for example, here in this case, it is actually the release of glucose from the glycogen with the help of glycogen phosphorylase enzyme. Further, rearrangement of cytoskeleton, activation of certain specific genes in the nucleus were also initiated due to this particular process. Thus, cell signaling helps to ensure that important processes are taking place at the right time and in the right cell in a properly coordinated way.